What's going on, everybody? This is Cody, the home theater hobbyist, and today I have my full review of the Definitive Technology BP9000 series. They sent me a pair of the BP9060 floor standing speakers, a pair of the SR9080 surround speakers, and the center channel, the CS9040, and I've had a chance to spend a few weeks with it. Now, one thing I can say about a lot of DevTech owners is I've heard from them in the comments section, and they really like their speakers. And honestly, after spending some time with these, I can see why. Now, I will say that this is probably gonna be one of my longer videos, so you can definitely use those chapter markers there to find the section that you're most interested in. But I'm gonna talk about the technology, I'm gonna talk about the design, and obviously I'm gonna talk about sound quality, so let's get to it. Before we get too far in this video, if you want to purchase the BP9000s or anything else from Definitive Technology, use those links in the description below, because it does tell our affiliate partners that you support the home theater hobbies. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't, because that also supports the channel. Well, here I am with the BP9000 series from Definitive Technology, also known as DevTech. And this series is actually targeted at the home theater, home cinema buyer. But if you're a music lover out there, they also have the Demand series, which is what they target towards the music lovers. But one of the things I noticed when I was looking at this series is they don't have a traditional bookshelf speaker. They have a surround speaker like you see over there, but they don't have a traditional bookshelf. And I thought this also kind of led itself to the whole home theater kind of thing, right? But before I go too far down that road, I am going to talk about these in a few different categories, and I'm going to rank them at the end of each category from 1 to 10. 1 being the absolute worst and 10 being the absolute best. And I think I'm going to start with features today. Now let's move on and talk about features and technology, and I'm going to focus on the BP9060s because this is where a lot of the features and technology really are, right? This is a full range speaker, meaning that you do have an active powered subwoofer down there, and it will play down to an audible 20 hertz. But I'm not going to start there. I'm going to start up top with the tweeter and mid-range driver. You have a tweeter and mid-range driver on this front face, but you also have them on the rear face. And the idea there is DevTech wants to be able to reflect off the wall behind you to give you a wider soundstage and a better surround sound experience. I also tried these in, you know, as far as moving them closer and further away from the wall. I started at 4 inches from the wall and moved out. And what I found was I actually prefer them to be about 13 inches or so from the wall to give me decent depth to the image, but also to give me a nice surround kind of sound to them. So that's what I recommend. I recommend placing them somewhere around 13 inches from your wall if you can, but you can definitely try that out for yourself. Now, I probably need to prove that the front and rear array works, so let's go ahead and let's hear a quick audio sample. Okay, hopefully you enjoyed those audio samples. Now let's move on and let's talk about the bass section of the 9060s. And we'll start with the bass radiators. Each 9060 has dual 10-inch bass radiators built in. And the way bass radiators work is you have a woofer cone there, but no electronics. So the air inside the cabinet is what's causing those woofers to move in and out, and it creates a little bit of extra bass. That is the same way that the bass radiator on the CS9040 works as well. Now let's move on and let's talk about these subwoofers. Each cabinet comes with its own subwoofer. So you buy two, you'll end up with dual subwoofers. Now you need to make sure that you're going to set these up near a power outlet, because these are powered subwoofers and you will need to plug them in. But I'll also say, when you set these up, you want to set these up as tower speakers, not as subwoofers. If they're not in the optimal place for your subwoofer, that is okay, because you do have two of them, so you're going to get better balance based within your room. So one thing I haven't talked about thus far is the height module. And DevTech has built in a way you can add height modules to the floor standing speakers, with the exception of the BP9080X. It comes with the height module with the package. But with the other speakers, you can buy the A90 Hyth module to go along with it. And what they've done is they've integrated into the package so it looks just fine and it just sits on top quite nicely. Now to get to it, what you'll have to do is you'll have to take this top plate off. You just give this a little push down here in the back and it pops up front and you can lift it. This is probably made out of aluminum because it does have just a little bit of weight to it. It's also got this brushed metal surface finish and the Definitive Technology logo down there at the bottom. Along the back is sort of this felt that feels pretty nice to the touch, so it's nicely designed. But once you pull that off, all you have to do is take the Hyth module and sit it on top. There's a little connector built into the back and it just snaps into the connection right here on the module, and all of a sudden you've got Atmos speakers, or Atmos enabled speakers, I guess I should say. And what that means is you can listen to your Dolby Atmos and DTS tracks with the sounds reflecting off your ceiling and down to your main listening position. But just make sure that your ceiling is flat and is anywhere from 8 to 14 feet high for the effect to work. In the features and technologies category, I give this a 9.5 out of 10. This is a full range speaker. You've got forward facing sound, you've got reflected sound, you've got bass radiators, you've got Hyth modules. You can basically do everything that you want to do with this. You even got a little light down there that you can turn on and off, which is pretty cool. The only thing I can think of that they could add is maybe a remote control, either Bluetooth or just a standard remote control, so you can change the bass volume levels from your chair versus having to get up and change them. But otherwise, I think they've done a great job, and I give them a 9.5 out of 10 for features and technology. Now let's talk design, and I'm going to start with the BP9060 and the CS9040, then I'll move on to the surround speaker over there. But the first thing you notice about these two speakers is they are covered in black speaker grill cloth, and it's kind of interesting, right? Because that's not a normal thing that I've seen on speakers. And so I was kind of looking at them and trying to figure out why that is. And my theory is, since there's so many drivers on the front face, rear face, on the front and top of the center channel, they just decided to cover the entire thing in speaker grill versus having, you know, sort of quote unquote, almost randomly placed speaker grills. And I find that to be kind of interesting and kind of a cool thought. Now, personally, I do like removable grills so I can kind of see my drivers, but I'm okay if this is the decision they had to go with just to make this design. But overall, this has a minimalist design, and you got these nice edges here. And along the center channel, you can see you've got this aluminum accent around each one of the edges. And I think it looks nice because it adds a nice little pop of color. Right here is a Definitive Technology logo, and I think that looks really nice. And down here on the front of the center channel and on the bottom of the tower is a D, and that logo lights up if it has a powered subwoofer. When I was watching a movie, I didn't find the light to be distracting, but it can be turned off with a button on the back if you need to. Moving over to the BP9060 towers, the top plate is aluminum, as I said, and the bottom base is also made out of aluminum. It comes with adjustable height, carpet spikes, and floor pads to protect your floors. Now let's talk about the SR9080 surround speaker. And as you can see, it is a bipolar design. It has drivers pointing in this direction and drivers pointing in that direction. That causes them to reflect out and give you a wider dispersion pattern. Up the center is a piece of piano gloss black surface finish that has a D logo down there at the bottom, and that does not light up. There's also piano gloss black on the top and on the bottom of the speaker. I think these surfaces are probably wood based on the density when you tap on them, because they don't feel like plastic, and I think that is nice design. In the design category, I give the BP9000 series a 7 out of 10. I like the minimalistic, modern design of the cabinets, and honestly, the speaker grill coverings has actually kind of grown on me. Do I wish it had removable grills so I could see the drivers? Yes, I do, but I'm okay with it. I'm also happy about the fact that the speaker grill cloth actually doesn't pick up as much dust as I was thinking it would when I first opened these up out of the package. I haven't had to use a lint brush on them or anything like that, but you can always use a lint brush if you need to. I like the fact that it's got these aluminum edges around the center channel and on the tower speaker because it adds a nice pop of color. But that also kind of brings me to something that I don't like as much, and that is the fact that the surround speaker doesn't have any real aluminum on it, and I wish it did because it would tie in a little bit better with the other two speakers. Okay, so now let's go ahead and let's talk about the actual connections you need to make all of this work. And we're gonna start with the 9060 because it's the most complicated. Both the center channel and the SR9080 are a bit simpler, so we'll do those in just a moment, but let's go ahead and start here. First and foremost, on the back panel of the speaker is where all your connections are. On the left-hand side here, you've got your speaker level connections. The ones on the top are for the Hyth module. So you're gonna plug the speaker level connections into here if you have the Hyth module, and then plug the Hyth module in at the receptacle on the top of the speaker. Now, the reason why DefTech did it this way is just to clean up your wiring a little bit so you don't have speaker wire draping down the back of the speaker. You've only got it down here at the bottom. And I like that. I think that's a nice design touch. Just below that are the actual speaker level connections for the physical speaker itself. So this is what's going to drive your tweeter and your drivers within this cabinet. The good news is it accepts all major speaker connections, including plugs like this, banana plugs. It also accepts spade connections. So you can just slide that into that little slot right there and then screw it down. And bare speaker wire. So it accepts basically everything that you need. Now we'll say this, you just have to pull these little caps off so you can do banana plugs. And just remember, black with black and red with red, both on the speaker and on your AV receiver or power amplifier. Now, next to that is the volume control. And this volume control knob here is specifically for the powered subwoofer in this cabinet. This does not control the volume on the woofers or tweeter, just the subwoofer. And I'll talk about that in a minute when we start talking about AV receiver setup. Up here up top, you have an LFE input. And this is how you're gonna take a subwoofer cable like we have here and connect it to your AV receiver in the subwoofer out connection with the other end, if you decide to use that. Now, obviously you'll need to do this for both speakers if you decide to go this route. And if your AV receiver only has a single subwoofer out connection, you can pick up a Y cable like this one. It's got a male end that you plug into your AV receiver and two female ends right here that you can use with your speaker wire. If you don't have this, I'll put a link in the description below so you can buy something like this on Amazon. But just below that, you have the power connection right down here at the bottom. So you just take your power cable, plug it in like that, and you have all of the connections that you need to make your speaker work. So let's move on and let's talk about how you're gonna set these speakers up with an AV receiver, because there's two major ways that you can do it. The first way is how I have it here. I've got the speaker level connections here, no subwoofer cable. Now, once you do that, you need to go into your AVR's setup menu and you need to set these speakers to large. And you're gonna say no subwoofer. You can set your other speakers like the center channel, the side surrounds too small as well, but these need to be set to large. And what that tells your AV receiver is to send all the frequencies over the speaker cable to the 9060s. Then the internal crossovers inside the 9060s will send the correct frequencies to the correct drivers. So the high frequencies will go to the tweeter, the mid-range frequencies will go to the mid-range driver, and the low frequencies will go to the bass driver. Now, one word of warning. Once you set these to large and say subwoofer no, if you run your auto calibration software, what you're gonna find is you will not be able to set the bass level. So you will need to use something like this sound meter or a sound meter on your phone to actually set the levels. And you can set them, you know, using the volume knob. I typically set mine at like 77, 78 dB at my main listening position, but you will need to use that because you can't use the setup mic from your AVR to set them up because you don't have a subwoofer. So just thought I'd put that out there. Now, I did try this setup methodology and what I found was that the bass was just a bit boomy. It lacked detail. And I think that has to do with just how the AV receiver was kind of sending out those frequencies. So what I did was I tried the second method, and that includes using a subwoofer cable like this one, plugging it into the back of the speaker and into the back of the AVR. And then I went back into the setup menu and I set these speakers to small and I set a crossover at 80 Hertz. When I did that, I noticed that there was a lot more detail in the bass and I liked it. I tried various crossover settings and I found that I prefer 60 Hertz and these speakers set to small. So that's my recommendation. You can try it, you can see which one you like, you can try them large, you can see what works for you, but my recommendation is to set these up as small and set your crossover at 60 Hertz. And again, once you do this, you can actually go in, run your auto calibration, and then you can set your levels using the auto calibration software if you want to. As for the center channel and side surrounds, again, they accept all the same speaker connections as the BP9060s, so that is a good thing. Going into the AV receiver setup for these, again, I would set these to small, even if you get the models with the subwoofer built in on the center channel. I'd set it to small and use that LFE input and just mess around with the crossover setting so you get that nice detailed bass. Let's move on and let's talk sound quality. To test these speakers, I used a Yamaha AVR, a Denon AVR, and a 7-channel power amplifier, and all of them drove these without any problems. They're pretty efficient at 92 dB, so you should be able to drive them with standard equipment. I mean, something severely underpowered probably won't work, but standard equipment should work just fine. I tested both movies and music, and honestly, I like what I heard. But before I talk to you about that, I'm going to play a couple of audio samples just to prove that these make sound.
Move. You can't see us if we don't move.
Hopefully you enjoyed those audio samples. Now let's go ahead and let's talk about sound quality. All the features, all the tech, all the setup, it matters. But what really matters is how these sound. And I'm happy to report that I really enjoyed listening to the BP9000 series. It reminds me of a band in which every instrument or every musician has their particular role. And when they play that role well, you get something that is music and you enjoy it. And that's kind of how this is, right? Like I said, I watch movies and I listen to music. Now, as far as listening to music is concerned, I didn't listen to a whole bunch of 5.1 music. I mainly listened to some 2-channel stuff. And so I'll talk about that specifically with the 9060 more so than the surround speaker or the center channel, because they're not really built for that type of thing. Will they play music? Yes. But really, if you're looking for music with these, you're going to want to go for this, not a side surround, because that's not a stereo image. But anyways, let's go ahead and let's start with the surround speakers, and then I'll move my way through the line and tell you my experience. Okay, so we're gonna start with the SR9080s. And the good news is these are surround speakers. They've got that bipolar array and they surround you in the sound. Their high end sounds decent, but I wish there was a little bit more clarity. The mid range is also decent. And the bass is, it goes down to around 40 hertz and will play decently at 50 hertz. So overall, the frequencies that it'll play all the frequencies that you generally need for a surround experience. And again, it works. One of the scenes that I use for testing is a scene in Jurassic Park where they are lowering a cow into a little paddock area so they can feed the velociraptors. And then once the velociraptors start eating, they basically attack it. And all you hear is, you know, the sound of the leaves moving and all that kind of stuff all around you. These reproduce that very, very well and very convincingly, even in a 5.1 setup. Now the DTS:X version of that movie actually has overhead sounds. It actually play over the Atmos speakers, and you can hear the leaves rustling over your head. And this has a pretty convincing height to the image as well. Now, will it replace Atmos speakers or anything like that? No, you should definitely go with those. But it actually does add some height to the image, which I like, and there's even a little bit of depth. So the SR9080s actually do a very, very good job as surround speakers. Moving on to the CS9040. This is going to handle the bulk of the vocals whenever you're watching a movie, and it does a great job. Whether it be a male actor or female actor, it produces very natural sounding voices, which is what you want. From a high end standpoint, I actually really like the high end in this as well. It's got nice clarity, nice detail, and the overall image, the overall soundstage actually has some nice depth to it, which I like. Now, the one area that this doesn't work as well, I mean, it works, but not as well, is in the bass department. You've got the bass radiator on top, and it's spec to play down to about 50 hertz. And I played a 50 hertz tone, and it's a barely audible 50 hertz tone. It really kind of comes into its own at 63 hertz. So it's not going to play super deep bass. It plays bass, but it's not super deep. Like I said, I'd set the crossover for this particular speaker at set it to small and set it at 80 hertz and let the woofers inside the 9060s or, you know, whatever bass you have going on, I'd let that take care of the bass. But this does a good job. The other thing I'm happy to report is when there is something that pans from left to right, you know, from left speaker through the center to the right speaker, there's no tonal change. There's everything matches as you go across the soundstage from the 9060 to this 9040 back to another 9060. And that is a good thing, because that's what you want with a center channel when you have something panning. So they've done a good job with this. The only thing I'd say is deep bass. You're not going to get deep bass out of this. So move up to the 9060 or the CS9080 if you want deep bass. Moving on to the BP9060s. let's talk soundstage. We're gonna start there. The soundstage on these is great because you have the reflective sound. It really works. You got a nice wide soundstage. And like I said earlier, I had to pull them off the wall about 13 inches or so because that gave me a nice wide soundstage, and it also gave the image some depth to it, because when I found that they were a little too close to the wall, the image just didn't have enough depth. So you gotta kind of play around with that. And even with music, I found that I had to pull them out even further, maybe like 19 inches or so, just to really get that musical depth that I wanted in there. So you will have to kind of play around with them with your setup to see what works, but it does work. It does give you a wider soundstage. And what DevTech said is that, you know, they want to widen the sweet spot. And I think that works as well. When you move over a seat or two, you still have a nice wide sweet spot. These also have nice height to the image, not Atmos height, but there's still height to the image. When things are supposed to be high, they sound like they are high. Moving on to the different frequency ranges, the aluminum dome tweeter works with the high end. The treble part actually works. You get nice clarity of sound. I was listening to some orchestral music and I could hear those violins playing very, very nicely. It was nice, clean sound. But I will say that there's just a little bit of detail. There could be a little bit more, let's say, extra detail in the high end. If I had to rank the detail on a scale from 1 to 10, I'd say it's probably like a 9.3, 9.4. So it's really good, but there could just be just a touch more detail at the high end, but it was nice and clean where it played. Now, moving on to the mid-range, one of the things I noticed about this package overall is it's got a little bit of a laid-back presentation, and I liked it. But in the mid-range on the BP9060s, I did notice that vocals were just a little bit flat, in my opinion, just a little bit. And so I moved over to the CS9040 just to hear how vocals compared, and I like it here. There's a little bit more emphasis, and it sounds a bit more natural coming from the 9040. And that's what I mean when I say that as a package, this all works together and kind of complements one another, and just sounds good when it's all put together. Now let's talk about the bass, because, you know, it's all about that bass, right? These do a great job in the bass department. I am happy to say that. The fact that you have two towers gives you that balanced bass within your room that just sounds, it sounds good. It's nice and balanced, which is what you want. Like I said, in the setup section, initially I had these set up with speaker level connections and large no subwoofer. And I found that the bass was just a bit boomy. But once I set these to small in my AV receiver, plugged in that subwoofer cable, I started getting the detail that I was expecting. And it does sound good. These play down to 20 hertz. Now, do you need a dedicated subwoofer in addition to this? No, not necessarily. If you want one, definitely pick one up, but you don't need it. I will say that if you're gonna go for a dedicated subwoofer though, at least go for a 10 inch subwoofer or something bigger, because that'll give you a bit more depth and even a bit more output, because these do a good job. Now, I did try these and compare them against a single SVS PB1000 10 inch subwoofer. And again, these held their own because you got two of them and I only had a single PB1000. Now the PB1000 did play a little bit deeper, but again, these play down to 20 hertz, an audible 20 hertz. So they do their job. I also found these were just a touch more detailed, but I had dual drivers going versus that single PB1000. So anyways, these do a great job in the bass department and I'm happy to report that. So after saying all that, I give the BP9000 series an 8.5 out of 10 for sound quality. I mean, this whole package works together very, very well. You've got a nice mid-range for your vocals coming out your center channel. You've got bass coming out your tower, along with some decent high-end and some nice wide sound stage since you've got that reflected sound. And then you've got the side surrounds just filling everything in your sides and rears if you have them for your rears. So I think this package just does very, very well together. Like I said, they're not perfect. I mean, I wish there was a little bit more depth in the cabinet. You kind of got to figure out where that's going to sit in your room just right. I also wish that, you know, maybe these had just a little bit more bass and a couple little things there. But honestly, from a home theater standpoint, these work very, very well. So I give them an 8.5 out of 10. The final category I'm going to rank is value, and I give the BP9000 series a 6.5 out of 10. There's a couple of things I really like about this, and it's really about the towers. First and foremost, they are truly full range. You don't have to buy a dedicated subwoofer. You can, but you don't have to. And they also offer different sizes of what I have here. There are a couple of sizes of full range speakers here, full range towers, that are smaller than this one. There's the 9020 and the 9040 that are smaller than this one and also a little bit less expensive. The other side surround, the SR9040, is a little bit less expensive than this one. This is the least expensive center channel, and they kind of have a couple that go up. So you can kind of find the one that matches your budget. And again, you don't have to buy a subwoofer and you can kind of match your budget. So for value, I give it a 6.5 out of 10. Okay, so we're at the end of this video. Let's wrap this up. What do I think of the BP9000 series? Well, based on all the scores that you've seen, I highly recommend the BP9000 series, especially for a home theater environment. Now, if you are looking for, or you're more of a music lover, I'd probably go for the Demand series. I haven't tried it, but based on my experience here, it's probably pretty good. Now, if you are 50-50, 50% movies, 50% music, I'd probably go with the BP9000 series, mainly because you have those built-in subwoofers down there along with the rear reflected array, so you're gonna get a good experience. Yeah, I would just say that, just go with the BP9000 series. The good news is this series has, you know, different price points. You can get a little bit of a smaller tower, you know, to sort of meet your different budget needs. So that is a definite plus. But again, the good news is you don't necessarily have to buy a subwoofer with these because they work so well. Can you buy a subwoofer? Yes. Will it make the experience even better? Yes, especially if you get a 10 inch or, you know, bigger subwoofer. I wouldn't worry about an 8-inch subwoofer if you got the 9060s, because they're going to kind of drown that 8-inch out. But otherwise, this is a great series. I highly recommend it. If you want to purchase anything from Definitive Tech, use those links in the description below. Sorry this video was so long, but I really had a lot to say. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment. We'll talk to you next time.